what can they get done? This composition normally is really aggressive, but lately we've seen the Rogue Mage compositions, including Rogue Mage Paladin, being able to bring it into the late game. And then you have the consistent damage of a Fire Mage, the consistent damage of an Assassination Rogue, and sort of the late game potential of a Paladin to stall out the game if you really want to. But Choccy Milkman, they're not afraid to get aggressive early on, looking for an offensive play here on a Jamie. Drainer denies Ratcher with a bash. Good denial by Drainer. Look at how aggressive he's playing in Feral.
Clyde is running blinding lights, so I think Choccy Milkman are going to do an all-in kill, try and bait a trinket with a blind if they don't find it early on. Otherwise, they'll be able to rely on that extra Paladin crowd control. So Clyde won't have a lot of stuns this game, not running the Repentance, but Blinding Light shares Diminishing Return with Cyclone, and obviously their team doesn't have a Cyclone, so they effectively have two of that Diminishing Return with Blind and Blinding Light from the Rogue and the Paladin. I'm waiting to see when the Choccy Milkmen decide to pull the trigger on that crowd control chain. Right now, they're getting bodied. Zizon's pushing all over them. Clyde waiting in anticipation to engage on that crowd control. Perhaps they're waiting for Drainer to slip up in cat form and feel comfortable before engaging, but they're falling significantly behind the longer that they wait. Drainer jumping in. Clyde gets interrupted. Ratcher in trouble, low on health. Mercy trying to close it with a Chaos Bolt. Goes for the Mortal Coil, fearing Gelu, trying to stop the Greater Pyros. Interrupted by Ratcher. Ratcher wants to go after Drainer. Drainer switches Lifebloom to himself. Clyde wants to move. If they can go with the Avenging Wrath activated, that's going to be a lot of extra damage. They're attacking Drainer. He's in bear form. He's anticipating it. He pre-iron barks it, manages to stay alive throughout the stun. Mercy switched to an imp, I believe, and dispelled the Hammer of Justice. Beautiful timing by Mercy with this, what do you want to call it, pet control on the Warlock. I've not seen a Warlock switching pets this actively. Usually they pick one or the other for the entire game, but Mercy is switching pets mid-game to try and gain the biggest advantage at any given moment. But this is the blind attempt onto Drainer, and he's looking to try and sit through the crowd control. Jamie with Astral Shift reduced a lot of damage, but it may not be enough on its own. Drainer is still crowd controlled. Jamie's on the run. He's going to use Demonic Gateway. Drainer's going to follow him, and they survive the blind onslaught. Now they don't need to be worried about the blinding light. Should it arise in the near future, they will still have a Glider's Medallion to remove it.
Yeah, I think with this particular strategy, with Mercy opting to run the Imp to dispel crowd control, they basically have no choice but to just go after Drainer. They went for the blind play, tried to get some damage rolling on Jamie, but they couldn't even get a trinket. And with Drainer not in crowd control, I really just don't see how Choccy Milkman at this point of the game can kill Jamie. Greater Power Blast being cast out, that's the one downside for Mercy not playing the Fel Hunter, is he's going to have to deal with those Greater Power Blasts. Now switching up his pet, has the interrupt available if he needs it. And like we've been talking about, Mercy, he's been making moves. He's really impressed me this tournament.
Yeah, Mercy is certainly stepping into the shoes of, I would even say, legends like Walrick's on Warlock, even arguably Chanimal as well. He's definitely looking to be like a top contender, and this is only cup number two of this new roster. I can't wait to see them in cups numbers 3 through 6. Drainer, though, in crowd control, and Jamie's very low on health. This is a scary moment for Zizon. They stop the crowd control chain, they get Drainer out, and now he is beginning to stabilize. Mercy's counter-aggressing onto Gallo Baba. What surprises me the most is that the Choccy Milkman just watched Method Black win with the Rogue Mage Druid. Why would they not just also play Rogue Mage Druid? Perhaps it's just that only Method Black's Rogue Mage Druid can beat them, and if that's the case, then is Method Black the best Rogue Mage Druid in Europe? Choccy Milkman have a chance to prove whether or not that is true if they can take down Zizon, but I feel like the Rogue Mage Paladin is, unless they play for the Colo strat, an inferior option over the Mage Rogue Druid.
We'll have to see what they can get done. I mean, Choccy Milkman, they always come in with the game plan. Clyde still hasn't revealed he's playing the Blinding Light. If the Drainer messes up even a little bit, they can really punish. Combustion gets traded out here by Gelu. They're looking to get aggressive on Jamie. Jamie actually gates away. He's across the map. Drainer's still in crowd control. Can he connect the Ironbark? That's the most important thing. Doesn't even go for it. Lightning Lasso going to be used over onto Clyde. They have big damage rolling. Ratcher moves in to back him up with the Garrote Silence. Now still good pressure over onto Jamie. Drainer, his mana relatively even with Clyde at this point. Gelu kind of just a 1v1 with him and Mercy in the midfield, interrupting Mercy on that Fel Hunter. Jamie still in a lot of trouble. Ironbark has to be used, and Drainer now trades out his trinket.
All right, Drainer. Now that Blinding Light strategy definitely could pay out for the Choccy Milkman. I feel like they've been holding on to it pretty much the entire game, waiting for an opportunity to go all in for a kill. Vendetta up in about another minute. Are they going to get to it? Gelu's under fire from Jamie at the pillar. Ratcher swings across, stopping the Lightning Lasso, holding Jamie in place. Drainer doesn't even seem to care that Jamie's being attacked. He's charging at Gelu. stunning him up. Clyde's moving in for a stun, but gets intercepted by Mercy. If they can prevent Clyde from getting to Drainer just a tad bit longer, it's going to be important. Drainer's going to reposition. Again, it's all about cat and mouse, although in this case, Clyde is actually the cat and Drainer is the mouse, trying to avoid the Paladin and avoid the Hammer of Justice as long as possible. And that way they can force the Paladin to fall behind. Paladins don't heal basically at all while they're moving across the map, so repositioning a lot. And they can also catch Clyde when he moves in midfield with these fears. I do like the positioning so far from Zizon, and I would say that everything is going according to plan so far for them.
Yeah, but Choccy Milkman, they have the Blinding Light in their back pocket, and I think that's one thing I've seen them do before. They don't reveal that extra crowd control, so if Drainer just slips up for a minute, all Choccy Milkman need is one good setup. With Vendetta, with Combustion, they can kill Jamie through every single defensive cooldown. Drainer actually getting targeted down as he's playing really aggressive, and I like that Choccy Milkman aren't afraid to play a little bit aggressive onto him. If he's going to push in with that Feral Affinity Cat form, you can really punish, get damage rolling. Ratchet, if he lands a Kidney Shot, Drainer could be in a lot of trouble, but he backs up before Kidney Shot's available. And of course, Jamie and Mercy are there to back him up. Fear on Ratchet into a Lightning Lasso. Big damage potential here for Zizon, but Gelu looking for a Dragon's Breath. He's looking for a greater Power Blast. Can he find it? And I don't think, I mean, despite his best efforts, I don't think Gelu's gotten a single greater Power Blast off this game.
Although, if he's running the Kolo strat, it's just to tank interrupts so that Clyde can heal and they get to dampening and then overwhelm the Destruction Warlock. They've been attacking Jamie a lot, maybe pre-dampening that is the right decision, but I think post-dampening, when we're getting close to the 30, the 40% mark, I actually do think they should switch to the Warlock and just overwhelm the team with damage and pressure. Clyde getting set up on here from Zizon. A little bit of a surprise there. I was not anticipating an attack on the Paladin. They actually committed one of their Gladiator's Maledict trinkets, so they don't really even get anything for that. They just lose out on one of their Gladiator Maledicts. I think that was a whiffed attempt at the healer by Zizon. You're going to lose a bit of momentum as a result of that. Stormkeeper's up. Jamie wants to blast somebody. Who is it going to be? It looks like Gelu down to half. Clyde, though, has Avenging Wrath. Drainer knows that situation is getting a little bit too risky, so he's going to reposition far away, try and drink, regenerate mana, extend for a late-game victory. But I'm not sold that they have a late-game victory simply because there's an Assassination Rogue versus a Destruction Warlock, so this could potentially backfire for Zizon.
There's no doubt about it. Drainer was able to escape. He recovered all of his mana, but sometimes the Druid can't even spend his mana fast enough through the damage that the Choccy Milkman are going to have available. Big potential here for Jamie. This is going to be a lot of damage coming in from Mercy. Drops the Infernals. Dark Soul. Gelu's in a lot of trouble. He's trying to spam out the Polymorph, so reversing the pressure onto Jamie at this point, but Gelu's still under fire. Dragon's Breath on Mercy to slow him down. Can he get in a position to get some damage rolling? Clyde responds with his Avenging Wrath, able to top off his team, completely stabilized despite all the offensive cooldowns Zizon committed and 20% dampening. That really shows you how powerful that cooldown is for the Holy Paladin.
There are big implications for this series. Choccy Milkman currently with 40 points coming into the tournament, Zizon with 60. So the winner of this could pass the other if they get a top performance and a first place finish. They could even potentially overthrow Wildcard Gaming's third position or even Change My Mind's second place position. So this entire bracket at the moment in terms of point standings could be totally changed depending on the victor. Zizon obviously with, I would say, more to lose because they're already ahead on points, but Choccy Milkman, considering their spring performance, they could have qualified if they didn't make so many roster changes. This time around, they have a second chance to not make that mistake. Hopefully they stay together as a unit, having already accumulated so many points, even with just a third place finish, should they finish here. Gelu using Shadow Meld on a Chaos Bolt and a Gladiator's Maledict, a 2-for-1 there, but he's still low on health. Jamie's Lightning Lasso doing a bunch of damage. Clyde tries to get a big Holy Light, almost got dispelled on it, but managed to sneak it in. Gelu still taking a ton of damage. It does appear that they want to pressure Mercy, but Jamie is capitalizing on the opportunity to dish out some damage while he is no longer the focus target. Stormkeeper up. Gelu's hexed. Clyde's falling behind. They're going to switch to Clyde once again. Drainer is chasing him down in that Feral Affinity. Jamie Polymorph. Drainer looking like he wants maybe a Warstomp Cyclone. Now caught into a Dragon's Breath. Double Dragon's Breath into a Polymorph. Greater Pyroblast. Desperately here from Gelu. Not going to try and go for it. It's too long of a cast time. They get denied on the recast of Polymorph thanks to Lightning Lasso, so Drainer should be able to save Mercy. They're on a bit of a clock here. I don't think they're at high enough dampening to overwhelm Mercy just yet, but Clyde's running out of cooldowns. His team's still very low on health. He needs 3 more seconds, 2 more seconds. He's in a 1 second fear. Maybe a bit of a mistake there from Mercy, putting Clyde on fear diminishing return. Regardless, Gelu's going to Ice Block. They overlap with Blessing of Sacrifice. Cooldowns are falling apart for Choccy Milkman. They're choking a little bit before the finish line where they can kill the Warlock and falling apart.
Jamie with a nice Thunderstorm denies the Ring of Frost. They needed that onto Drainer in order to take down Mercy. And now Mercy in a situation where he has every cooldown. Gilu's going to be in a lot of trouble. There's not much defense here for Choccy Milkman. I don't know how Clyde is going to be able to heal through this. Gilu looking for a greater Pyro Blast, unable to find it. But after this Avenging Wrath for Clyde, this is the moment when Zizon need to push in and get aggressive, because it's almost impossible that Clyde's going to be able to heal through this damage unless they make a big offensive push. Drainer Trinkets out. They still haven't used the Blinding Light. I don't think they've revealed it yet. I mean, I could be wrong, but I haven't seen it.
I keep refreshing just to double check, but I'm pretty sure he is running the Blinding Light. And maybe he's forgotten.
They might just need one Blinding Light. They might just reveal it right at 30, 40% dampening. That's when they make their all-in attempt. Drainer trinketed out of blind, so they have that extended crowd control chain, but Gelu has to hold on. Big damage coming in from Jamie and Mercy. Can Choccy Milkman survive? They have Vendetta. They have Combustion. They have all the tools they need to take down Mercy. They just have to execute.
All right. Can they execute? Can they finish the Choccy Milkman here in game number one? They certainly have the pressure. Clyde uses Divine Shield, but they overlap cooldowns earlier. There's really nothing but Holy Light to save him. He catches one, but needs way more than one. I think it's going to be done here for Gelu. He's going to get crushed under the weight of Zizon. No openings there for Choccy Milkman. They don't press Blinding Light leveling the spring season. They took one of the earlier cups with that Death Knight Warrior composition. So that has been a back pocket composition that's worked for them in the past and could work out for them here in this cup. And if they win, that is a huge point gain for them overall to potentially qualify to the summer finals, only in cup number two. And they're still a new roster. They still have lots of time to improve even beyond the current power level that they are at. Drainer and crowd control. Jamie the target here early on for the Choccy Milkmen. Curious if Clyde is running that Blinding Light or if he's up to switch it out, because he didn't even press it one time in that last game, and he did. He is not running the Blinding Light this time around, which makes me wonder if he forgot.
I mean, that would be quite the blunder. If he picked the Blinding Light, maybe he didn't have a key bound, or maybe just completely forgot about it in this matchup. But definitely unfortunate, but I think the talent choice is going to be a good swap up for them. Gelu taking big damage early on. This is really scary. Ultimate Sacrifice already gets traded out, and Choccy Milkman looks like they've just entered a blender. Zizon doing so much damage. All three members low. Clyde trying to play catch-up right now with his Avenging Wrath. Does manage to do so, but I have to say that's not a great start for Choccy Milkman.
Not a good start at all, and this is their map pick. This is their comp advantage. If they lose here, I mean, it's pretty much lights out for the rest of the series. I think we're going to see a repeat of Zizon versus Method Black in the grand finals to decide our winners for European Summer Cup number two. Gelu has control of Drainer, but Ratcher is doing no damage to Jamie. It makes me think that he has switched his build back to the Pack Spirit Azerite traits. No, it doesn't look like he yet. No, he's got one. I'm double-checking two. He's got three. He's running that Pack Spirit build again. I mean, it's keeping him alive right now. Lightning Lasso on Gelu. Gelu decides to use Gyre's Medallion to break out of the stun, which means he won't be able to later on. He's definitely going to be a target now for Jamie moving into the future. That Ghost Wolf build, pretty effective so far. Jamie has often switched between the Purge, Dispel, Heal, and the Pack Spirit. This time around, opting for the Pack Spirit, having seen that he was the main target. He could get all-in as well from the Rogue Mage Paladin, so it makes sense that he wants to be much more durable. The Rogue Mage Druid is a little bit slower pace of damage, so it may not be necessary for him to run it in that specific matchup. So I do enjoy that he's willing to change up his builds, given the matchup being so different. Double stun from Mercy, fear on Gelu. Big push here, potentially for Zizon, but they're disrupted. Now it's Clyde in a fear. Gelu's still the target. Jamie trying to build some Maelstrom. He's got zero right now, so that bar below his health is Maelstrom. When it fills up, he can then use pretty powerhouse spells like Earthshock and do a ton of damage to a target. So right now he's very low on Maelstrom. He's not going to be that much of a threat. Choccy Milkmen are pushing on top of him, realizing that, looking for a kill, but Drainer activates Iron Bark. This reduces damage on the target that it's applied to. In this case, Jamie, he's going to be all right. Now Jamie tries to counterattack while he's durable with Lightning Lasso. Gelu uses Counterspell to counter that. And now Jamie is once again on the defensive. Mercy has been left open for some time. I'm curious to see how much he can get done given this freedom. Drainer jumps into the fight, trying to add some extra damage onto Gelu. Clyde gets feared. Good usage of this uptime from Mercy. Gelu very low on health. Blessing of Sacrifice from Clyde. Fortunately, this time around, not overlapped with the ice block. You definitely can't afford to make a mistake at this level of arena play, especially when qualifying to the finals is on the line.
I mean, there is a lot on the line. Fear on Gelu. He gets feared up again. Lightning Lasso onto Ratcher. And Choccy Milkman, they've just struggled in this matchup so far to find any sort of damage. It really makes me wonder why they're locking in the Fire Mage Rogue Paladin. there always is the potential with this composition that they can just get one crowd control chain that goes their way and get a big all-in attempt onto Jamie. And Jamie running these Azerite traits does kind of limit his offense a little bit. He's not going to be able to play as aggressive. And in the late game, those Pack Spirit Azerite traits, they don't end up helping you that much, especially in dampening. They all get reduced in their effectiveness, and that's when potentially we see Choccy Milkman making a really aggressive push. There has been good damage here for Zizon. If we look at mana, that might be one thing that Choccy Milkman is considering. They can just go after Jamie, consistently run that Kleptomania spell steal, and as long as they can deny drinks, which they're not doing right now, then they could have a mana lead. But if Drainer is able to just sit and drink to full, it's a complete disaster for the Choccy Milkman. Drainer was able to recover around 20% of his mana. And if he's able to escape like that, keep getting out of combat, sitting down to drink, and slowly but surely get his mana back to full, I feel like Choccy Milkman is losing out on a big opportunity.
It is a bit of a disappointment here, Choccy Milkman locking in hook point, because the greatest strength of the map is supposed to be that you can stop the enemy healer from drinking, but they're not even doing that, not taking advantage of their greatest strength here on hook points, which is spelling grim times for their team overall. However, we have seen other teams such as Never Lucky running the Rogue Mage Paladin. If they make it into those deeper stages of dampening, they can just outright kill a Destruction Warlock. So we may see that potentially in the near future should they make it to that late game point. Mercy again switching out his pets for that Imp to dispel Polymorph, then switching back immediately to a Fel Hunter. I will say his pet control on the Warlock to remove crowd control is on points. I'm just going to say it again. I've not seen Warlocks actively switching between their pets. They usually just pick one and play with it the whole game, but he is actively predicting crowd control, anticipating it, switching the pet, dispelling it, switching back to interrupt the next one. It's really top level Warlock play. I would say almost at the skill cap at this point in terms of defense on it, and he's a newcomer to the tournament scenes here in the Arena World Championship program, and he's certainly getting an opportunity to shine. Drainer in a Polymorph, Jamie isolated. He's on the run, but in Ghost Wolf out of line of sight of Gelu, I think that he's going to be all right with that Pack Spirit healing the Spectre Recovery. Gelu needs to try and strip that off, but doesn't look like he's got the Spell Steal available, so Jamie's Ghost Wolf going to tank out all of that damage. Now Zizon should look to get aggressive. It looks like they want to go after Gelu. How is Clyde going to respond? He activates Avenging Wrath. Big boost to healing, big holy light. Gelu's back to full. Now he's trying to lead the charge for the team, interrupting Drainer's heals. Jamie low on health, tries to reposition with the Demonic Gateway. Clyde gets a Hammer of Justice. Ratcher reconnects. Jamie in a lot of trouble. Meteor coming in from above. Jamie trinkets and runs out of the Meteor, avoiding its damage, trying to make it back to Drainer's side so he can catch a couple of heals. Jamie playing excellently when isolated for such an extended period of time.
Wow, you can see the crowd. They're very excited with the plays happening in the game right now. Lots of love for these two teams. Jamie going to be taking some damage still as Choccy Milkman kind of struggling to find momentum, but they have been doing a decent job on Jamie so far. Gela with good control over onto Mercy. Jamie putting out some counter pressure on the Clyde, and I'm kind of wondering, maybe Clyde's a vulnerable target here for Zizon to try to pressure down a little bit more in this matchup, especially if he's playing really aggressive onto Jamie. That is a potential for them, but I'm not sure if that is necessarily the best strategy. Mercy getting aggressive. Infernals being dropped out into a beautiful Capacitor Sun. Drainer in cat form. He's getting a lot of damage rolling. And this is this effect that Zizon has when they use all these offensive cooldowns and they pair together that Stunlock combo. They really get a lot of damage rolling, but Clyde was actually surprisingly able to heal through it quite easily.
Yeah, Clyde doing a great job for the team, trying to get to that deep dance beneath stage and overwhelm the Destruction Warlock. That has to be what they're playing for. On hook point, they were hoping to stop drinks, avoid the fight, get into deep dampening, overwhelm the Warlock, but they are also being overwhelmed. I will say Zizon's offense is solid on this Destruction Warlock, Elemental Shaman, Druid, potentially enough that they could maybe overcome Method Black in the final should they make it to that point. Bit of a blunder here on the part of the Choccy Milkman. They break their blind. That is a very important crowd control on the Rogue, the most powerful crowd control, in fact, and breaking it means you get absolutely no benefit. That should allow Zizon a lot of breathing room here to run down Choccy Milkman. 2 seconds away from Avenging Wrath, 1 second away, caught in a Mortal Coil. This is probably a Divine Shield if Clyde isn't careful. He's playing a dangerous game, trading out Divine Shield finally here, but that's a powerful cooldown out of the way. Zizon fully capitalizing on that mismanagement of blind. Now, once again, the Polymorph being broken out. Drainer reconnects with Jamie around the corner. He should be able to hold on to his Astral Shift as a result. Ratcher stunned, can't really do too much damage. Beautiful defense and flow between offense from Zizon here in this series. I mean, they've improved drastically just in this tournament alone.
I mean, I wonder if Zizon can get to that grand finals, if they're going to be able to give Method Black a run for their money. We'll have to see. Choccy Milkman in a bit of a desperate situation right now. Clyde, his mana is not doing great. Big damage coming in from Mercy. Clyde, he has no Divine Shield. It's going to be a time that Choccy Milkman, they have to make their final push. They're slowly getting whittled down. Jamie, although, with that Pack Spirit build, as we kind of talked about later on in Dampening, that build is not nearly as effective. And all Choccy Milkman need is one good setup, one big burst of damage where they can take Jamie down. And that could be something we see quite shortly. There's a Polymorph on the Drainer. Kidney Shot on Jamie. Is this going to be the push, Sid?
All right. Is this going to be the push? Doesn't look like it. Jamie not even getting scratched. Clyde now very low on mana and interrupted. Ratcher gets Earthquake stunned. Could have got bursted down. That's a bit unlucky there if he had actually gone down to that. Jamie deciding to use an Earthquake, which has a chance to stun a target, a random chance to stun a target. Jamie now in a stun once again, but got into Ghost Wolf. It doesn't look like they have Spell Steal, so Jamie, I actually think he might have just died right there if he wasn't in Ghost Wolf, but now looks to counterattack. Mercy's looking to close the game out, chasing down Clyde. If they can dispel off that Divine Favor, they can't. Mercy gets blinded. This is, we've gone from a blind being broken to a desperation blind now from Choccy Milkman. They just want to make it to 40% dampening and attack the Warlock. That's all they want to do at this point, and that's so blatantly obvious. Just get to 40% dampening, attack the Warlock, do whatever you need to do to make it to that point, but whatever it is that they need to do doesn't look like it's going to be enough. Jamie gates across to where Clyde was trying to escape, casting that Stormkeeper, gets interrupted, fortunately for Clyde, right when his Avenging Wrath came up, big Holy Light. Clyde stays alive as a result. Lightning Lasso on Ratcher. Ratcher uses Glider's Medallion to get out to stun Jamie and stall the fight. Mana even at this point. Dampening continues to ramp up. Clyde recovers once again, but when Avenging Wrath fades, he will be susceptible to being swapped to.
Yeah, we'll have to see if they take advantage of that swap. Drainer throws out the Iron Bark. Jamie does manage to survive because of that. But it fades, and now he's a vulnerable target. He still has the Astral Shift. Is he going to be able to get it out? Gelu and Ratcher, they have a big offensive push here. Vendetta Combustion available. They have to make something happen now. Hammer of Justice into a Polymorph on the Drainer. Mercy spams out the Fears. He's trying to keep him alive. Jamie running for his life, trying to just heal up the best he can, but he could just fall. This is Vendetta. A lot of damage for Ratcher. Gelu moves in. He's still not using the Combustion. He's waiting. He's saving it. I can't help but feel like it might have been a good moment. They had the crowd control on Drainer. It was partnered with the Vendetta, and they weren't even able to get out the Astral Shift or the Iron Bark, and now things are not looking good for Choccy Milkman.
I think they have to attack the Warlock. We're at 40% dampening, but Clyde's getting swapped too. He doesn't have much cooldowns. He could get soloed by Jamie in a Lightning Lasso if he's not careful. Jamie's still the target, but taking basically zero damage here during that Meteor Combustion attack. That is unfortunate. Iron Bark activated, although maybe at 40% damage, it doesn't matter. Mercy's trying to snipe Clyde at the same time, trying to fear Gelu.
No!
Drainer gets interrupted. Things are spiraling out of control. Dampening finally here at 41%, reducing the healing so significantly that neither team really can recover. Gelu's at sub 10%. Cauterize has procced. He's burning down. Has to Ice Block. Clyde needs 20 more seconds to Avenging Wrath. Drainer's going to Trinket Blind. Zizon have to close this in 15 seconds. Otherwise, Clyde's team's going to go back to full health. Can they close it? 11 more seconds. Looks like they're actually trying to run away. I don't know if they can afford to. If Ratcher overextends, though, he's going to walk into a bash. Big Gladiator's Maledict. If they can kill
big
him in the Stunlock.
Hold.
Big
Boom.
Hit under Ratcher. Big overextension. And Zizon move to match point.
Yep, Zizon with another solid performance.
Hitting so many spells. He's getting really high value out of that Warlock. And if Ratcher can just sit on him, Kidney Shot him, use Kick as an interrupt, they can really slow that down. And although it is difficult to get the crowd control onto Jamie, they can do simple setups like this. You Kidney Shot Mercy, Dragon's Breath Jamie into a Sheep, Hodge on Drainer into a Ring of Frost. I mean, I make it sound simple, but that is a setup you can rinse and repeat. And eventually, the consistent damage brought in by the Fire Mage and the Assassination Rogue might be enough to take down Mercy, because at this point, I'm not even 100% convinced.
I mean, the problem I see is that they're trying to take Kolo's strat, run around in circles until deep dampening, and kill the Warlock. But they forgot to kill the Warlock part, which I think matters a lot. Perhaps before dampening, Jamie is more susceptible and likely to die, and they can generate more pressure by targeting him. But deeper in dampening, it has to be the Warlock. Every single situation we've seen in these Warlock versus Assassination Rogues, if they get to that deep dampening stage, still have a decent amount of mana and cooldowns, the Warlock gets overwhelmed and falls over. So I want to see Choccy Milkman take that strategy word for word, not only half of it. If they can, then there's potential to reverse sweep the series back in their favor.
What do you think it is about this particular matchup that isn't, or why Choccy Milkman aren't wanting to switch back to that Rogue Mage Druid we saw Method Black find success with?
It could just be that they're one of those Rogue Mage Druids that Zizon smacks around.
Are they just wuss?
I mean, yeah, Zizon has said that there are some Rogue Mage Druids that they just stomp with their Warlock Shaman Druids. So this could be one of them. Clyde getting swapped to huge attack from Zizon. Mortal Coil, Mercy looking to get follow-up, interrupted on Fear, but Chaos Bolt now an option. Clyde ducks for cover downstairs, but Mercy's right on top of him, casting Chaos Bolts, counterspell faked out, now polyed. That's a bit unfortunate for Mercy. He really wanted to end this, but maybe Jamie Kent Drainer jumps in and manages to pull the Divine Shield. So even though Mercy wasn't having the best time with his push, Jamie and Drainer certainly capitalized on the moment.
I mean, you guys kind of mentioned that there are some certain Rogue Mage Druids that Zizon kind of smack around, but on that same token, it seems like Zizon's just kind of smacking around Choccy Milkman, but as I say that, they are making a nice little push. Trainer Trinket out of blind into a full polymorph. Jamie actually on the run at this point. Hammer of Justice. This could be the setup that they need. Ratcher trinkets out of Lightning Lasso. Jamie gets in line of sight of Drainer. I think at this point in the game, Drainer should be able to keep him alive quite easily. The threat is gone. Mercy swats Gelu away with a nicely timed Fear that denies a lot of the damage, and now it's Clyde that's in trouble.
All right, Clyde, what are you going to do? Zizon are getting really aggressive, and that's probably because they have two games that they can afford to lose, so they're going to go for a riskier strategy by targeting the healer. But if it works out, the series is over, and they advance to the grand finals. If it doesn't, then they can go to their map pick, their comp pick, and set up a better situation for themselves. So in my mind, it's win-win either way here on Dalaran Sewers for Zizon. Can they find the kill on the Clyde? I mean, looking at his cooldowns right now, he is highly susceptible to death at this point in time. They're pinned at the boxes. They're hiding. They're trying to recover, but they're also trying to make it to dampening. That is the main objective here for the Rogue Mage Paladin against Destruction Warlocks. Just make it into dampening, and then the important part, kill the Warlock, not the Shaman.
I thought you were going to
let
me guess.
Druid. I kind of thought about leaving it open.
Hey, guessing game.
I didn't want to leave you on the spot, okay? We don't need that extra stress on the desk.
I think I would have been able to figure it out, but maybe not. I could understand why you didn't give me that opportunity. Mercy looking for a Chaos Bolt, managing to find one Drainer and a Kidney Shot. And now, Choccy Milkman, they're trying to reverse the pressure over onto Jamie. They're getting a lot of damage rolling, but it looks like Drainer is able to survive just off of that barf skin. And any time they go after Drainer, honestly, I'm surprised how well Drainer is dealing with these situations. When he gets pressured down, he doesn't overreact. He doesn't overcommit. He really relies on Jamie and Mercy to back them up, or back him up. And they always seem to be there when he needs them. Big attempt now onto Jamie. Ironbark gets traded out by Drainer. Zizon should survive with that. That was a combustion coming in from Gelu. He managed to get off the Ironbark, but not necessarily the biggest win.
All right, not the biggest win. Mana still even, so no real advantage to either team there as we etch closer and closer to dampening, which will be a double-edged sword. While it does benefit Choccy Milkman to killing their target, it also benefits Zizon as well. Lightning Lasso onto Gelu. He is now the target. Looks like they've abandoned on trying to kill Clyde at this point. It could be a bit too risky. They want to maybe just mix it up also and try it. Whoa, what was that hit? Big attack onto Gelu. Bursting him down, but they don't panic. They don't overlap. They keep it calm, cool, and collected in that situation. Stormkeeper interrupted. Opportunity to try and push Jamie over, but not enough damage. Drainer positioned with Innervate, spamming out Regrowths. Big heals for free. Well-timed there. Easy recovery. Jamie sitting through a Stunlock combo, but isn't even dented. That was a Gladiator's Maledict. Now we see Drainer jumping in. The attack is over. It is now kitty fun time for Drainer. He's going to be getting Rake Bleeds onto three targets and ramping up the area of effect pressure for his team. Jamie has Stormkeeper rolling. His Lightning Bolts are going to be blasting, and then Mercy now has Infernals. Is he going to call them in? It would be a triple. He's polyed. He can't, but afterwards he'll be on... He's actually going to trinket out, activate the Infernals. He's clotheslining the crowd control and getting a huge momentum of burst here, potentially. If Clyde is interrupted, it could be game over. He's not going to risk it. He uses Blessing of Sacrifice, but two targets are low on health. Clyde is still bashed. They're going to switch to him. A great strategy against that Blessing of Sacrifice as you get a little bit of extra damage on the Paladin as well, but with Avenging Wrath, Clyde's healing is too strong. He is now going to be able to recover. Drainer's trying to stabilize Jamie through Choccy Milk's recovery with Iron Bark, and it looks to be enough. And at this point, mana is still even, and it's too close to call in terms of who's actually going to take it, Vin.
I think Mercy is still running that imp. I don't know why they're not going after him. If you put a kitty shot on Mercy, I don't think he can use the dispel. So that would be able to shut down Drainer getting out of Polymorph for free consistently in this matchup. I think that's an adaptation we have to see Choccy Milkman make. Jamie, I think he's still playing the defensive Azerite traits. Not an easy target to take down, and Mercy's just been taking control of the game. Double Mortal Coil, now a Fear onto Ratcher. What is he going to do now? Looks for a Fear again on Ratcher, completely denying Choccy Milkman, getting out consistent damage. And I really feel like Choccy Milkman, at this point of the game, at 10% dampening, they need to start putting some effort onto Mercy. Get crowd control on Jamie, get it onto Drainer. I mean, it's easier said than done. But, I mean, they're just consistently going after Jamie, and it's not working.
All right, let's see if Choccy Milkman decide to switch their targets here. We're getting into dampening, and I really would like to see them target the Warlock instead of the Elemental Shaman, at least if they want to stay alive in the tournament. Drainer once again adding huge damage, triple Capacitator Totem there, triple Rain of Fire. The entire team dying at this point in time for the Choccy Milkman. Clyde's trying to power through it with Holy Lights, but it's not really working out. He needs that Avenging Wrath as soon as possible. Fortunately, soon is actually pretty soon for him, 13 seconds away. Jamie being pressured, but now in Ghost Wolf running away while Mercy takes control of the fight with Mortal Coil. Both teams begin to stabilize. Where is Drainer, though, amidst all of this chaos? Is he drinking? I think that he is. And if he gets full mana, that's a big lead for Zizon.
Yep, Zizon completely resetting the fight in terms of mana and defensive cooldowns. They basically have everything. Mercy waiting around a minute for both of his offensives. That big push to come back. Infernals as well as the Dark Soul. Choccy Milkman in a bit of a dangerous situation. Clyde, his man, is not doing great. He's at around 30% right now. Drainer denies the attack once again with the Iron Bark, but there was no real commitment by Gelu and by Ratcher. Things in this matchup are looking good for Zizon so far, but with this composition, Choccy Milkman, they always have an opportunity to come back. They have a lot of damage at their disposal. The Kleptomania Spell Steal, a huge tool for them to take down any Restoration Druid team. But they're going after Jamie, and it hasn't been working. It didn't work in the first two games. I don't know if it's going to work in game three. I just don't see the adaptation from Choccy Milkman.
Yep, targeting is still stubborn here for Choccy Milkman. Jamie's ramping up, pushing in for some big burst. How are the Choccy Milkman going to deal with it? Divine Favor, quick heal from Clyde. They could even target Clyde, but he's got Divine Shield again, so he is unlikely to die. I mean, at this point, all three targets have their defensive, so anyone is a target. They defensively blind. Again, Choccy Milkman are just trying to stall, but I think they're stalling to kill the wrong target. We see Polymorph dispelled by the Imp. They're just letting that go unpunished. Drainer gets out of crowd control for free. Iron Bark is more than enough to survive that attack. They have Astral Shift for the cooldowns, although maybe at 24% dampening, they could overwhelm through the Astral Shift. They put Jamie on stun diminishing return. I can't help but feel that that was maybe a slight mistake on Ratcher's part. They're actually using the kidney shots on Mercy now, but attacking Jamie? I'm not sure what's going on with the Choccy Milkman right now. It's so obvious that they want to play for the dampening strategy, but it doesn't seem obvious that they know what target is going to be the best for them. They still feel the Shaman is the best, and I mean, perhaps they can kill him, but they're just getting owned right now while Mercy's left open to dispel Polymorphs, left open to just Chaos Bolt and Fear. Big push here with Vendetta Combust, but Jamie once again has Astral Shift. He repositions with Pack Spirit, healing him up while Drainer sits through the crowd control. Drainer can use the Gateway to get back if he needs to. He's going to use Wild Charge. Ratcher has to use Cloak of Shadows as he overextended. Didn't get the kill. Had to trade his most vital defensive cooldown to push for nothing. I mean, maybe in the next stun they kill him, but if they don't kill him in the next one, I'm pretty sure Zizon walk away with this.
Yeah, Mercy just waiting once again for that big push with the Infernals, with the Dark Soul. And once that's available, I don't know what Choccy Milkman is really going to be able to do. Clyde has to save his Avenging Wrath. Luckily, it lines up quite nicely. All three members of the Choccy Milkman behind the pillar, but there's no clear opening. There's no clear win condition at this point. They're going after Mercy, and maybe this is the surprise effect that they needed. Choccy Milkman has done this in the past, where they hide their main strategy, their main intention, for a long period of time in the game. And now, at a point like this, potentially the point of no return, this is when they can start executing on that strategy. They can go after Mercy and Drainer and Jamie. They might not be prepared for it, and they could catch them potentially off guard, but doesn't look like that's what they're going to be doing. Once again, committing a kidney shot onto Jamie, Drainer into a full Hammer of Justice, but Mercy is able to just free cast Fears. He denies Gelu any crowd control. And I think Jamie's going to be just fine.
Yeah, Jamie's recovering. His cooldowns are rotating back up and available, whereas Ratchers aren't. Clyde has a little bit left in the tank, though. But if he gets crowd-controlled, he won't be able to heal, so he needs to be a bit careful. They're still posted up at the pillar. We're now getting closer to 40% dampening. With Jamie's defense rotated back up and available, there's no way. Stop attacking the Shaman. Attack the Warlock at this point. All three targets are basically at the same point in terms of cooldowns. So it's the same amount of time required to kill no matter who you target. But the Warlock is just more likely to die than anyone. But they keep going after the Shaman. They catch him in a smoke bomb. Drainer gets blinded as he runs in. But he got Iron Bark connected prior to the smoke bomb. So this Iron Bark is stabilizing Jamie. He gets caught in a polymorph. But Mercy's there to dispel it. The Dew Hammer of Justice to dispel. Clutch play by Clyde. Perhaps it's enough to take down Jamie. Vendetta's activated. Where's the Astral Shift? They're trying to hold on to it. But I mean, at 40% damage, I don't know if you can just afford to hold on to it. Looks like you can. Jamie running away. That Pack Spirit, super effective. Drainer now finally out of crowd control. Maybe they don't need to. If they can get away with it, it's a big lead. And they'll be able to push Choccy Milkman around. It looks like they're going to get away without having to use the Astral Shift. Now I want to see Zizon just stand on top of them. 41% dampening. Close it out. A minute away from the Avenging Wrath. Dispel off the Ring of Frost. They can't. Mercy gets polyed. Actually, you still can. Okay. Drainer gets dispelled out of it. Now the Kidney Shot Drainer. They swap. This could be a big swap. They're dropping the Meteor. Dropping it in huge damage, but nope, not going to be able to kill him through Barkskin. Ratcher low, Gelibaba low, Clyde low, mana low, everything low. The only thing that isn't low is dampening at this point in the game, and that's only going to be benefiting Zizon even further as they look to close out match point here shortly. Gelu holds on with Ice Block for his final stand. Clyde holds out for Divine Shield on his last stand. Ratcher still has Cloak at least in the bank. If they're desperate to kill somebody, they're going to be going after Drainer. He anticipated this attack, though, has Iron Bark already active on himself. And because he anticipated it, he's able to weather the storm and stay alive. Now his team can start walking all over Gelubaba. Big damage here. Blessing of Sacrifice in the nick of time. But
oh, Drainer's in trouble.
Clyde, Drainer needs to be careful. He's spending a lot of time on top of the Choccy Milkman. He's going to gateway to safety. Clyde has Avenging Wrath, though. I think he's actually going to be able to stabilize here shortly, even despite the 48% dampening. If Clyde manages to stabilize, Drainer could be in trouble. I still can't help but feel this. Why aren't you targeting the Warlock? It's almost 50% dampening now.
I really have no idea. They're going after Jamie. Once again, he has the Astral Shift. What is he going to do? Here's the Gateway also. Jamie's just going to hightail it out of there. Mercy, he moves in. He's looking to close out the game. Gelu with Combustion, trying to get aggressive, but Jamie's in such a good position to survive. Mercy lends a Fear onto Ratcher. Once again, Clyde, Gelu, Ratchet, they're all trying to run. They're all trying to hide. Drainer throws in an Iron Bark onto Jamie to empower his heals. Negate that dampening just a little bit at this point of the game, but Clyde's completely out of mana. So is Drainer. He's committed quite a bit. I don't know what Clyde's going to be able to do. Honestly, at this point, it's anyone's game. Ratcher has Vendetta. They could make a big offensive push. Cloak of Shadows saves them from the Chaos Bolt. They're going after Jamie, but he has the Astral Shift once again. Why aren't they going after Mercy? I don't know why.
This is going to be a triple kill. I actually think we're going to see a triple kill witnessed here against Zizon. The targeting is just totally off here for the Choccy Milkman. They're finally targeting him, but they're dead. Why did they wait so long? Mercy had a bit of a panic attack, but now he gets to safety. The entire team is dead. Drainer's in cat form here shortly. Going to be walking all over him. One bleed for you, one bleed for you. Drainer's having the most fun ever in his life right now. There's still no Avenging Wrath for 30 seconds. There's no more blocks. There's no more cloaks. They're totally tapped out on cooldowns. And here it comes. We're closer and closer to that triple.
They kill Mercy here.
If they kill him here, it's like, what? Why didn't they do it just minutes ago? They're so close to killing him, but they've just run out of time. They're going to go out of the tournament. But they took so...
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.